Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I have an awesome video for you guys. It's pay dirt from Europe, Sweden to be exact. Well, the website is from Sweden. I ordered the pay dirt from Norway. As you can see, the description is very minimum. It's pay dirt from a town in Norway that is known for the gold fields, and you have a half a kilo or 1 pound of pay dirt in a bag. You see the price here in euros, 33.28 euro. There is not a minimum amount of gold guaranteed. If you go to the reviews, they're all in Sweden and 4 or 3 years old. That's very old. There are some grams mentioned in the review, so I think that's the amount of gold. I am not sure. Well, for 33 euros, you can't really. Yes, one, two pictures. Okay. I hope you guys will enjoy this video. And without any further delay, I'm gonna see how much gold I have for my pay dirt from Norway. I hope you guys enjoy. Okay, let's see what this pay dirt has inside and how many gold is inside. Inside is a zip bag. See if there is any material inside. If it leaked, nothing, that's a good sign. There's a note inside. Well, I don't know Swedish or Norway language, but what I make out of it is that there's between 0.3 gram up to 1 gram of gold inside. So let's hope we have the 1 gram. Make sure we have every last bit of material. This is what it looks like. It's not completely dry, a little bit moisture inside. I think I can classify it with just using the kitchen strainer. That's what I'm gonna do next. I'm gonna classify it one time, big and small material. Okay, I put a little bit of soap in the water to break the water tension, to make sure that gold that can float sinks so you won't lose it.
Okay, let's see if there's any gold in the bigger material. There's some. I hope you can see it at home. There are some bigger pieces. I count 4 of them in total. And some a little speck also. Nice flakes of gold, maybe even a small picker. Here also. Okay, I'm gonna collect this gold and go on with the finer material. Okay, I switched the smaller material, the classified material, in another pen because this pen is smaller. It's the only one I have that fits in the in my water. Now what I didn't do with the spay dirt is use a magnet to extract all the heavies, black sand, all the magnetic black sand. So I hope there isn't too much in it, because otherwise it will be very difficult for me to separate the black sand from the gold. I kind of forgot this, so I hope it doesn't bite me in the end, but we will see. One thing I do notice that the water is not getting dirty at all, which is unusual. It could indicate that all this pay dirt was already processed before the so-called tailings, and that he just used that to fill the bags and added some gold, which is fine of course, but there's no virgin grout inside this pay dirt, otherwise there would be a lot of dirty water. Okay, I'm done panning the finer material, and let's see together for the first time how much gold is in this pan. Already seen some color, appearing, gold color. A lot of fine gold. The reason why I'm tapping this, as you can see, all the gold moves to the edge of the pan and makes it more easy for me to separate it from the black sand. Because if you would have keep swirling, you would have taken all the gold eventually. If you repeat this a few times, you'll get all the gold from the black sand. See how all the gold moves to the edge? The harder you tap, faster it goes. As you can see where I tap now, all the gold goes to where my finger makes contact with the pen. And to prove this here, I'm gonna tap on this side. And all the gold is moving to where I'm tapping the pen. The more aggressively you do this, and I see a lot of beautiful gold. I'm gonna suck it up, repeat the process a few times until I have all the gold out, and I will show you how much I got from this pay dirt. So this is all the gold that was inside the pay dirt. I always check the pay dirt again after I pan it out to make sure I didn't lose any. That wasn't the case. So this is all the gold in the pay dirt. Let's have a little bit of a closer look. There are some bigger pieces in it, some flakes. Also some very fine material. Flower gold, almost. So this is all the gold that was inside. Here's the biggest piece. Next, I'm gonna put it all on the scale to see where I end. It's not 1 gram, I can tell you that already. Hopefully it's a little bit above the 0.3 grams that I think was promised in Swedish. I'm not sure. Okay, let's have a look. Okay guys, the reason I'm filming this by hand is because I noticed that after using the tear, the lamp of the tool I'm making to make the video to get some extra light for better quality actually warms up the plate, and you get a reading that isn't correct. So I'm filming by hand now. I already teared it, so it's minus 5.26 grams, the weight of the little bottle I have. So I'm gonna put it on now and see how much I am left with. It's a total of 0.37 grams of gold, exactly what was promised. Oh, it's going down now. What was promised between 0.30 and 1.00. So it's the bottom end of the promise. Yeah, you can't get lucky all the time. So that was it for this episode, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please like, subscribe, and leave a comment with any thoughts or ideas. I'll see you next time. Bye.